And welcome back to West Brom Fan TV. Now, back from Fleetwood. Very tired, boy. Obviously, it's the day after, but I'm still just as shattered. Strap yourself in, though. This is round two of predictions. Last week, I did all right. I got the Albion game right. And I got a couple of correct results right as well. Not the best, though. I mean, I got the Albion game, though, so. And it was a win. So, even better. Let's get started. We're starting off on the Friday night game as Coventry City take on Oxford United at the Coventry Building Society Arena. Very interesting game, to be fair. Oxford just coming up. Big result against Norwich last weekend. They looked all right, to be fair. Oxford, decent little team, to be honest. They looked like they did what I said I thought they were going to do in... my predictions for the season itself, the actual league table. I said they'd be good at home. They were good at home, no quality. Branigan, who we were linked with at some point, he looks like some player. Cov City, not the best start. 1-0 loss to Stoke. Apparently they were quite poor from what I've heard as well, obviously. Living around the area. I have a lot of Cov friends and yeah, they were okay. They weren't too happy, put it that way. But... usually when something like that happens, especially with a team like Cov, who are a promotion favourite, they bounce back. And it's going to be a good atmosphere, I reckon, near a full house there, hopefully. I'm going for 3-0 Coventry City. Now, moving on to Saturday, the early kickoffs. There's three of them, to be fair, which is the new Sky deal coming into play, which really everyone loves so much. we're starting off with Pride Park as Derby County take on Middlesbrough. Now, Derby, they got blew out the water by Blackburn, to be fair. I mean, they got two goals, which is great, but still, conceding four to Blackburn, not really the best start of the season, is it? Middlesbrough, on the other hand, 1-0 win. Latte Lath, what a bloke. He's looks like he's going to be up there as one of the front runners to win the Golden Boot. He's definitely one of the bookies' favourites. But yeah, I think they're going to follow that up, Middlesbrough. I do think that this is a promotion or a playoff season for them. I don't think it's going to be easy, though. Pride Park's a tough place to go. There's a good atmosphere there. I'm going for Derby County 1, Middlesbrough 2. Anyways, now moving on to another one of the early kickoffs: Portsmouth versus Luton. Portsmouth giving Leeds a good run for the money, to be fair. Could have won it, could have lost it at the end as well. But... a very valiant performance. Callum Lang with two goals from Wigan. I'm pretty sure he was playing his trade a couple of years back. He looks like a tidy little player for them. Yet again, got the Oxford effect. Bit of fire in their belly there. You know, they're fighting. And to get a result like that, especially at Ellen Road, hard place to go. Them fans are horrible when they're up against you. Just, it's really hard to get anything going. And they did well, very well, to get a point. Luton, on the other hand, it got absolutely squashed. Surprised. Before the game, yes. Watching the game, not at all. Burnley absolutely played them off the park. Men against boys, very much so. And I think it will take Luton a bit of time to get going. That's why I reckon it's going to be another draw for Pompey. It's going to be a 1-1 draw I'm going for. Anyways, moving on to the Baggies. We take on Leeds. We're the main game on Sky that weekend. Two of the big boys in the Championship. I think it's not me being biased in saying that. I'd say we are one of the big boys, and Leeds certainly are. Massive club. Obviously, big result for us. No one was really expecting Josh Maguire to come and play like that. Hat-trick. Everyone played really well. Swift was brilliant. Number 10 shirt and putting in a... absolutely superb performance. Same with Grant. Changed man, changed player. He was super. Fellows, decent. And Hegum, unreal. So, big result. Obviously, Leeds, like I said about that 3-3 draw against Pompey, very much a Leeds game. I think they should have probably won it. Leeds love an entertaining Championship classic, don't they? They can't escape it. But I can't see Leeds dropping points again, to be honest. They've got too much strength, and they are due a result against us at the Hawthorns. And putting my negative cap on, I think Leeds are going to beat us 2-0. Yeah. Hopefully, I don't get 2 out of 2 and get that one right. Hopefully, the Baggies prove me wrong. Moving on, Bristol City versus Millwall. Bristol, a 1-1 draw, quite unfortunate at the end, give away a penalty and lose at that late on, 91st minute, Estupiñan. But, yeah, Tommy Conway, I've just seen it come up on my phone literally a few minutes ago, potentially going to Middlesbrough. That's going to be a big loss. And they are very much just a mid-table side, Bristol. I mean, I'll probably get proved wrong and have egg on my face at the end of the season when the summer go up. Millwall, bit of a shock, really. Watford beat them. I thought that, you know, Millwall at home is always a tough place to go. I thought that they'd get the job done. But they didn't. They lost 3-2, a couple of sloppy errors, to be fair. Do I think they're going to lose again? No. Do I think they're going to win? No. It's going to be a stinky 0-0 draw. There's always a couple every week, aren't there? And this is going to be one of them stinky 0-0s. Moving on to the fantastic Burnley. What a side. Scott Parker, the guy who knows the Championship, don't he? And some of the players they've got absolutely oozing with talent. I mean, I know Dara O'Shea is potentially leaving, a former Albion player. He was quality. Some of the attackers they've got, they just, like a knife through butter through the Luton defence. They play some lovely stuff, honestly. As a neutral, if you give me a team to watch, I'd watch Burnley in this league. They are just unreal. And they've just signed Ronaldinho's son. I know, interesting. Cardiff, on the other hand, not the best start. 2-0 loss to the Macums, Sunderland. Did surprise me. I thought they might get a result. Actually, no, I didn't. Sorry, I did say Sunderland will win. I'm just surprised by how much they rolled over, I mean, and let their bellies get tickled. I thought they'd be a little bit better. What do I think the score's going to be? I think it's going to be another, well, not easy, but hard-fought win for Burnley. They've just got too much quality. They've got too much for anyone in this league. Even Leeds, I think they've got more quality than. I've gone for 3-1 Burnley. Off to Carrow Road now. They started the season pretty disappointingly, losing to many people's favourites for relegation, Oxford United. A bit of wind. 2-0 at their stadium, which, the Cassam, there we go, got the name. Blackburn, on the other hand, big win, 4-2 against the Rams. I don't think anyone thought there'd be that many goals in that game. Many were expecting a 1-0 stinker, mostly, I bet. Or, you know, a 0-0 draw, but they got it done. Obviously, Carrow Road is a tough place to go, but I think Blackburn are going to get another result, you know. I don't know why, I've just got a feeling that they're going to win again. So I'm going for Norwich 0, Blackburn Rovers 1. I don't know, interesting. Moving on, Plymouth versus Hull. Plymouth absolutely got battered. Shocking performance. Some of the defending was calamitous, Sunday league quality, and I think Plymouth fans will agree with me. Hull, a 1-1 draw, like I said, nicked it late on thanks to Estupiñan. This was a big game at the end of last season because Hull thought they were going to nick the playoffs, and Plymouth were fighting for survival still on the final day, and they did win 1-0 and we got the playoffs, so happy days. What I think the score is going to be, I think Rooney's going to get his first point on the board. It's going to be a boring 0-0 draw, which we all hate. I think this is going on to Bramall Lane. Sorry about that. Sheffield, first game of the season. I did watch this game. They looked all right. Preston looked pretty shocking, to be fair. Both goals were just, one was a fluky deflection. The other one was poor goalkeeping error. They've got quality, though, obviously. Even though they got pummeled every game last week in the Premier League, they're still got some decent players in that team. QPR, on the other hand, like I said, we beat them 3-1. Their man marking was atrocious, to be honest. However, saying that, they're bringing in some interesting players. They've brought in Karamoko Dembele. He was at Blackpool last season. Used to be a massive wonder kid. He was at Celtic. He's a pretty tiny little player, to be fair. So what do you think the score's going to be? I think that QPR will bounce back and Sheffield United will suffer their first defeat of the season. It's going to be Sheffield United 0, Queen's Park Rangers 1. Moving on to the Swansea.com stadium as they take on Preston North End. Now, Swansea obviously starting the season with a loss to Middlesbrough. Not the greatest. Didn't really see much of that game, to be honest. ITV are horrible with the highlight show, so you can't see much. So they just showed the goals and a couple of odd things. Preston, on the other hand, I did actually see them and they looked absolutely woeful, to be fair. That's what I mean. Ryan Lowe literally stepped down after one game. No disrespect to P&E fans, but it was just an absolute stinky performance. I think they'll all agree as well. So, what do I think the score's going to be? Swansea City 4, Preston North End 2. A few goals in that one, I think. Just got a feeling. Anyways, Watford versus Stoke is the next game we're looking at Vicarage Road. That horrible ground that don't sell beer. Shocking. Sorted out. Yeah, talking about Watford, what a performance on the opening day. 3 goals against a tidy Millwall side. I mean, they nearly bottled it late on. It was 2-2, but Rajovic nodded it in to get all 3 points. I was quite impressed by Watford. I think they have been sleeped on a lot. A lot of people thought mid-table fodder, but they've got some all right players. I like that Kembe. He's pretty decent, to be honest. And obviously, Jakey Livermore, a bit of experience in the lines. Rajovic looks like an absolute baller, to be honest. A proper old-school striker. Proper passionate, proper aggressive. Stoke on the other hand. Let's touch on them. A 1-0 win against Coventry. Lewis Baker with a goal. A good start to the season for them. Getting the ball rolling. Usually, they're a little bit slow off the marks. But it's nice to see Stoke doing all right, I guess, for their fans. What do I think the score's going to be? I think that Watford are going to carry on and push forward and prove people wrong. I'm going for 2-0 Watford. And I think that Rajovic is going to get a goal again. The absolute man mountain. Moving on, final game of this game week. It's on the Sunday. I think it's a 12 o'clock kickoff. And I've gone for a bit of a shocker for my prediction of this one. A bit of a shock for the week. So Sunderland take on Sheffield Wednesday. Can't get the words out. Mammoth clubs in the league. Arguably the two biggest. I mean, Leeds fans, West Brom fans, we may disagree. Yeah, Sunderland starting the season off with a 2-0 win. Some decent goals, I guess. Nice to see them doing well, I guess, because they are a big club and they should be up there. Sheffield Wednesday, they absolutely blew Plymouth off the park. But saying that, I think that I could have probably scored a goal against Plymouth on that Sunday because they were atrocious. So, another Sunday for Sheffield, and Sundays for Sheffield Wednesday always smells like goals. So, what am I going for? Sunderland 0, Sheffield Wednesday 4. I know, I think they'll do it again. Bit of a weird one, but there always is a weird score thrown in there, aren't there? There's always a proper shocker that you just would not expect, that you have to make sure that you've got your contact lenses in or you've got your glasses on to know you've actually saw it. So some of the fans watching, don't be offended. It's just a bit of fun. It's just a prediction. And by last week's predictions, I'll probably be wrong because I only got one correct score out of a lot of them. But thank you all for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Obviously, I won't be doing the vlog this weekend. It'll be C-Dog, the main man, Connor. Good to see him. His lovely face back on the channel, won't it? I guess we'll be fed up with mine, because all I do is just drink booze and moan, usually. Not last Saturday, but yeah. Anyways, I'm going to wrap it up now. Thank you all for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe and get your predictions down below. I was having a little nose at them, to be fair, a little gander. And yeah, it was interesting to see what you guys think as well. Because we do read the comments and we love it. Yeah. Up the Albion, come on you baggies. And fingers crossed, I am wrong and we get a result. Cheers and bosh.